Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, we're adding cool things to our Tinkercad house. If you haven't made it this far, there will be two lessons up here in the corner. They each take a little more than 10 minutes and you'll have a house looking just like this. Now we're trying to get basic skills and have a ton of fun at the same time. Friends, today we're going to use the hide command so we can see inside. You've got the shadow of the roof so you know where things fit, and let's add a cool table and chairs. Before we get building though, friends, I do want to bring back the white background color. I am also going to bring back the grid. It just makes things look better for building. We're going to build a table with the cube. Simply set it down, shrink it to the measurements you think fit for your table. I'm going to let you pick whatever numbers you want. I'm going to choose a thickness of 1.5. I'm also going to pick a color that I think is cool. I'm going to make a brown one. And I want to click on it and round the edges. So I am going to type 5 and press enter. Notice that gives me a nice rounded table shape. Friends, we are going to make legs with that cube as well. Hold down shift and shrink it. We're going to go all the way down to size 2. As you get close, you can stop and just type the number as well. Now the height we're going to use is 13. You'll notice that this fits the window height I had. You can adjust yours as you need. Now I'm going to move this close to my table and hit F to fit view so I can zoom in. I want this table leg to be just inside the table. I'm going to click on that and do Control D. Use the arrow keys to move it to the other side. Now that I've got those two, I'm going to select them. So I just drag and connect, do Control D, and I'm going to shift nudge and then find the exact spot I want to put them at. Now I want these four legs to stay as a group, so I'm drawing a little box that touches just the four legs. Notice it says 5 shapes. That means I got one of the pieces up above. Let's try a skinnier line. There I've got my 4 shapes, and I'm going to group them. I'm also going to pick a custom color. I'm going to go down here into this brownish area here. I like that right there. So now you know how to get to custom colors. And then finally, friends, we're going to put this on top using cruising. Press C for cruise and then just lift it up and set it on top. Now because this is a group of these, notice how it's one large shape, we can now select it, choose L for align. Doesn't matter which one you pick, we want to choose middle and middle, and look at that. You have got a fantastic table almost instantly. Now friends, that was fun and fast. Watch this. If we do Control D and we move this over, so we're going to use it also for our chair. I'm going to take all of it and I'm going to do shift squeeze until I get it so it looks like a chair to me. So I think that's decent for the bottom of the chair, but I want to make it thinner. Since we did not group that, we can just adjust it. These also can adjust. They get thinner so it fits automatically. Now that it's a square shape, I can shift stretch until I'm really happy. And then are you ready for this? We can just do Control D. We want to rotate it from an angle. You'll be able to see this a little easier right there. If we do shift rotate, it goes 45 degrees at a time to hit that 90 we need. I'm going to put the work plane, W, on top of the chair, hit D for drop, and then we can just nudge this to the back with the arrow keys. I'm going to use the black handles to make it a little thicker and a little taller, and bingo, we have got a decent chair. Sink it down in. I think that looks pretty cool. First, I'm going to put the work plane on the ground. So friends, there is my cute chair. I'm going to click on those two pieces and pick a different color. Let's go with a custom, something in the blues. I love playing with these different techniques. I can select that chair now and do Control G. That groups it into one piece. Notice it changed to one color. We're going to click multicolor and fix that real quickly. Finally, I'm going to shift select my table. And I'm going to do Control G for those. Same thing when I'm done. I need to turn on multicolor. I'm going to zoom back out to home. I'm going to put my table in the house. I'm going to put my chair in the house. And let's do show all to bring it back. to help me arrange stuff. I'm going to take off the roof. Let's look at it from the actual top. If we zoom in, we can grab our table and put it where we want. If you find out that the sizes aren't quite what you were thinking, this is where you can shift squeeze and they'll keep their shape and you can get them exactly as you want. I'm going to shift squeeze to get that in there. I want two of those chairs, so I'm going to do Control D. There they are side by side. If I want to put two on the other side, I can shift select those and do Control D as well. I'm going to shift nudge, and friends, here's another nifty tool. This is the mirror tool, and it flips them the other way. Of course, we can do show all, and we can hit the home button so we can see our house from the outside. Now, friends, I'm going to change this to table and chair. And I'm about ready to publish it. Before I ever publish, though, I do always pick a different color for the background. And I also like to shut off the grid. I think that looks much cooler for screenshots. Now we can, of course, back out. And you can easily show the world what you created by clicking on properties. Make sure you've got a name. Of course, I put in the description mentioning that the tutorial is coming soon. Add your cool tags. Don't forget, if you put the tag HLMT23, I search that tag almost every day, and of course I'll give you a reaction. Finally, set it to public, and then I always choose attribution, no derivatives, because I want you to come up here, follow the tutorial, and gain some epic skills. Friends, as I wrap up, I just want to remind you about my website, HLModTech.com. I've got a tab dedicated to Tinkercad with tons of awesome categories. And then below that, you can find my day one favorites and also useful starters. And then finally, the Tinkercad essentials. Friends, also at the bottom corner, I want to share the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Lastly, friends, don't forget the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, we've got more than 700 members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL ModTech. Of course, friends, don't forget you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL ModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.